Hi everyone, it's Jen, and welcome back to another Friday Reads, which is actually happening on Saturday this week. So I'm sorry I could not get my Friday Reads up for you yesterday. It has been a really challenging week for me, pain-wise. Wednesday night, I had the worst pain I've ever experienced in my life. Like, a C-section was nothing compared to this sucker. It was some sort of pain attack, which right now I'm attributing to my fibromyalgia, but we're actually really not sure where it's coming from. But it lasted 5 hours, and if I did not have Emilio and it was 2 o'clock in the morning and I had no place to leave him, I absolutely would have went to the emergency room for the first time in my entire life. I could not deal with the pain. I did, but I guess I'm stronger than I think, but it was so freaking bad. I can't even explain to you. So I luckily had a doctor's appointment on Thursday, and my doctor has a suspicion of what it is, but he's not sure, so he set me up for some tests, and I'm on a lot of medications to try to just deal with the pain and try to stop it before it starts. So, you know, I'll keep you guys updated. I don't know what it is yet. I haven't had the tests, but we'll see. In the meantime, I did not get any reading done on Thursday or really yesterday. I mean, I got a little bit done yesterday, but Thursday, I only got 3 hours of sleep on Wednesday night. The pain didn't stop till about 2:30, so that was when I really fell asleep, and then I was up by 6. So it was long. It was long. But I didn't get any reading done on Thursday at all because I was exhausted. So that day was a total wash. I did finish an entire book on Wednesday that I started Wednesday, so that was good. And if you want to see the review for that one, it is up on Goodreads right now. It is a review book that I got that talks about, it's like a reading companion, and it's really, I forget the name of it at the moment. Let me see if I could look it up while we're talking. No, I probably can't look it up while we're talking. That would be rude. But it's a reading companion, and it talks about all different kinds of genres of books and suggestions that the author has given in all those different genres. I think she has like 5 to 10, somewhere in between there, of different books. I had read a lot of the ones that she had given, but she gives like a brief synopsis and why it fits into that genre. She also, in the beginning of each chapter, talks about her reading style, the reason she loves to read other people, and it's really for bookworms. So if you are a bookworm like myself and you like reading about books about books, this is a good one. You should definitely give it a check out when it comes out. I'll talk more about that in my July review, but if you're interested now, like I said, go to Goodreads, it's on there. So, like I said, I have had an interesting week for sure. Oh, and you know, it is Friday Reads, so Emilio is here and he's watching Mickey Mouse and playing with his toys, so you will probably hear all that going on in the background. My apologies. So I have some review books to read. I think I showed this one to you guys last week, and if you follow me on Instagram, you probably saw it. This is Watching Edie, and this is by Camilla Way. This is a review book. It's coming out, I think, in the beginning of August, or maybe at the end of the last week of July. I'm having a hard time getting into this. I'm not exactly sure why, but yeah. Emilio, don't do that. I'm having a hard time getting into it. I'm not really sure why. It's weird, and I'm not sure if it's my mindset or if it's just I don't like it, but I am going to continue trying to push through it. I really don't want to DNF books anymore. I mean, I will if I have to, if I'm like absolutely hating it, but I'm putting this one down for now because I'm not into it. Another one that I'm having the same problem with is this one that I showed you that I took from the library, Perfect Days, about the girl who gets abducted by the guy who's obsessed with her. I'm really not far into this one at all, and I think honestly on this one it's my mindset, because I can't even get through a few pages where I'm just like bored with it. And I honestly think what it is because of the pain. I need something easy, light, something that I really want to read. And to be honest with you, I finished The Wrath and the Dawn and I loved it so much. I told you, well, I don't know if I told you, but I did post it on Instagram. I went out and got this right after, and I I'm really excited to read it. I should have just picked it up that night, but I needed to read a review book because I try to alternate. And I just finally told myself last night, you know what? You feel like crap. You need to read something that you really, really want to read. And I really, really want to read this. So last night after work was over and we got all the things that we had to do done, I slept for like 2 hours and I got up at like midnight and I said, oh, this is awesome. Everybody's in bed. I'm going to like cuddle up on the couch and just gobble this book up. So I read for about 20 minutes and that was it. And I totally conked out. But like I said, I'm on medication, so like it's to be expected. But I read about 30 pages of it, and I just love this. I love it as much as the first one. So I am planning just to read this one this week. It's a chunker. This weekend. I don't actually know if I'm going to get finished with this weekend because of two things. Like I said, the medication's knocking me out. And number two, my birthday is next Sunday. I think it's next Sunday, whatever the 30th is my birthday. And we're going to an event tomorrow night for my birthday. So I'm not going to have a lot of time to read tomorrow. I will have some time today. But yeah, so that's what I'm reading this weekend. I'm just going to read this. And if I do somehow have a lot of time today to get through this, and I do get through it, because I've read the other one, which is like 500 pages in like 24 hours, and that was not reading straight through. That was working full time and taking care of a baby and all that. So I like blew through that book because it was fantastic. I loved it. I'm talking so much today. Sorry about that. This is a long Friday reads, but if I should get through this, I'm going to try to pick up one of those other two, and if I don't like them within a couple of pages, I will just pick up something else because that's what I need to do for me right now. And just so that you guys know, in case you do or you're not on Instagram, you probably wouldn't know. I did get an email about it this morning, but you know, that's the case. Thank you. He just hit me with a book. I'm not getting paid or sponsored to say this, but I'm saying it because I'm a huge Barnes & Noble fan. Today only, one day only, they're having a sale at Barnes & Noble. For members only, you get an extra 10% off. So every day you get 10% off all books, games, toys, magazines, stuff in the cafe. Well, for today only, they're doing a member appreciation. And I don't even know what today's date is. Today's the 23rd, right? Yes. So Saturday, July 23rd, one day only, they are doing a member appreciation. You get 20% off. So it doubles your member discount. So if you have something you have your eye on and you have a membership, go pick it out today because you get an extra 20%, an extra 10% off, 20% off. So that's awesome. So I'm totally going to Barnes & Noble today. I have, of course, my eye on something. So I'm just going to get it. And what else and if you're not a member, you can absolutely sign up now and get your discount today. So that's pretty awesome. So that's it, guys. That's all I have for you today. This was a long Friday reads, but I just wanted to catch you up briefly. I will be back Monday to update you on my weekend and my weekend of reading, and I will show you what I got in that Barnes & Noble trip today. So there's that to look forward to. So guys, thank you for watching today, and as always, happy reading.